Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 57th video class of DIP, we will study some basic morphological algorithms or applications in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. See, now that we have learned different morphological operations such as erosion, dilation, opening, closing, and hit or miss transformation in the previous video classes, we are in a position to understand some important morphological applications or algorithms. So let us start. This slide shows different morphological operations that we have studied in the previous few video classes. First is boundary extraction. The boundary of set A can be obtained by subtracting the A erosion of B from the image A, where we know that B is our structuring element. So here, from the binary pixels, we remove the pixels that are survived after the erosion process. For example, when we erode this image, as we have learned earlier, the contour or the boundary moves in by a certain amount based on the structuring element. Why? Because the erosion will remove pixels on the object boundary. So if we subtract the portion inside the red pen mark from the whole image, we will just get the boundary. So that is boundary extraction. So this boundary is obtained when we are using a 3x3 structuring element. If we want a thick boundary, obviously we have to choose a 5x5 square structuring element. Okay, let us implement in MATLAB. This is the MATLAB program for boundary extraction. We are reading the image circles and first eroding it and then taking the difference from the original image. Let us run and see the output. So we can see here that the boundary is extracted. Now if you want to get a thick boundary, let us change the structuring element from 3x3 to 5x5. Let us again run and see the output. So now we can see that we have obtained a thick boundary. Next is region or hole filling. Say this is the original image with a boundary which we want to fill using region filling. This is the complement of the image and this is the structuring element. Now we choose a point inside the region and start with that point as shown in figure x0. Now we repeatedly dilate this point as shown in figure x1, x2 and so on. But at every step, we don't want that the dilated portion to cross the boundary defined by A complement. And so we use intersection with A complement in this equation. And so we get the whole filled or region filled image like this final image. Let us implement in MATLAB. Next is extraction of connected components. The extraction of connected components from a binary image is central to many automated image analysis applications and it is very important. See, if the ones are 4-way connected or 8-way connected, then they are a part of connected components in this image. Here xk is equal to xk minus 1 dilation with B, whole intersection with A. Initially we can choose any one as x0, dilate it with B and intersection with A. Now the answer that we get will be our x1. And similarly we get x2, x3 and so on until xk is equal to xk minus 1. That means until we get both the values same. So this will be our connected components. Let us implement in MATLAB. This is the MATLAB program for extraction of connected components. And here we determine which is the largest component and we erase it. That is, we set all the pixels to 0. So in the text image, the largest component are two consecutive Fs that come in the word different and we'll be erasing these two F. Let us run and see the output. So see, this is the original image and here these two consecutive Fs are the largest components and they are extracted over here or removed over here. That is, they are not present in this different word. Next is convex hull. As the name suggests, convex hull is convex in shape. That is, it doesn't have any concave part and it is the smallest polygon that contains all the points in a given image. So convex hull says that it is the smallest polygon which can enclose whole of the object and it is very useful for object description. Here four structuring elements are used for implementation. First of all, x1 is equal to x of k minus 1 hit or miss b1 union of A. So here after finding all xik values, we have to perform union of them. Say that union is d1. Same we have to do for the structuring element b2, b3 and b4 and we obtain d2, d3 and d4. And finally the convex hull is the union of all d's. So it will give us convex hull shape like this. Let us implement in MATLAB. Next is thinning. As the name suggests, thinning will make the objects thinned in the image. It uses this hit or miss transformation, and here we only match the shape with the structure in the element and no background operator is required. Here B is a sequence of structuring elements. So the thinning equation is A hit or miss B1, hit or miss B2 up to Bn, and the entire process is repeated until no further change occurs. This figure shows an example of thinning the fingerprint ridges so that each is 1 pixel thick. This is the original fingerprint. This shows image thinned once, this shows image thinned twice, and this final figure shows image thinned until stability or no changes occur. For this figure, there are different structuring elements like this, and we keep on eroding this image with different structuring elements one by one, and at the end we are remained with only 1 pixel wide thinned image like this. Let us implement thinning in MATLAB. Next is skeletonization or skeleton extraction, which is similar to thinning, and it is one another way to reduce binary objects to thin strokes that retain important structural information about the shapes of original objects. So we know that skeleton is a concise representation of a shape. Skeletonization is defined as the set of all points that are equally distant from two closest points. So we can think that of the union of all the disk centers that are contained in the object. So these will be the disk centers. This shows another maximum disk on different segment of the skeleton of A, and this is the complete skeleton which will be obtained after skeleton extraction. Let us implement in MATLAB. And as we discussed earlier also, there are numerous gray level and color morphological applications such as morphological smoothing, morphological gradient, etc. And smoothing is obtained by performing a morphological opening followed by closing. Let us implement this color morphological smoothing in MATLAB. This program shows morphological smoothing, that is opening followed by closing. Let us run and see the output. So as we can see that the original image is smoothened after opening and closing. That is, the wrinkles which are seen here are absent in this image. Let us zoom and see. So you can see that the wrinkles which are visible here as well as here are absent in the smoothened image. So with this, we complete our chapter on morphological image processing. Thank you very much.